BBBsGive.org recently released a new survey. We call it the Donor Trust Report. It's an in-depth look into the state of trust in the charitable sector. We're excited to release this report because inside of it is information that gives us all a better understanding of how donors see the charity sector. I'm joined today by Roxanne Rucker, Vice President of Community Impact at KaBOOM, to share some of her views of our findings. Please tell us about KaBOOM's important mission and how you work to achieve community impact at the local and national level.
So first off, KaBOOM is the national nonprofit that's dedicated to ensuring all kids have great places to play. We work with communities all across the country. Over our 22 years, we've impacted the lives of nearly 17 million kids. We have a fundamental belief, and that is that the wellness of communities starts with the health and wellness of kids.
Does KaBOOM think of public trust as an asset? And if so, why?
Public trust feels like a commodity that's eroding today. There's so much misinformation and distrust of our basic institutions, government and others. Trust is absolutely essential to the work that we do. It can't be done without some level of trust between ourselves and the communities. The communities that we work with, we empower them, we respect their local context, their lived experiences, and that's fundamental to how we work with communities.
In the report, we delve into the state of trust for different types of charities. We also looked at how trust varies across age and race groups. We found that perceived trust for youth development organizations varies meaningfully across racial groups. For instance, while 14% of white respondents say they highly trust youth development organizations, about 25% of African American respondents say they highly trust these organizations. We also found that African Americans and Latinos tend to prefer donating to a charity serving the needs of their ethnic community. How has your organization worked to build trust and engagement with minority communities? Why is it important to your organization?
Yeah, well, first off, in ensuring that all kids get a great place to play, our work is primarily with kids who live in poverty, lower income, underserved communities. And more often than not, those communities are communities of color, African American and Hispanic. So that's the primary population that we work with. Our model is all about engaging the community and giving the community authentic leadership and voice in the project. So we don't swoop in and say build a playground or work with the community or tell them what we need, what they need. But instead, it's a collaboration, it's a partnership with that community where they benefit from our experience and our coaching. But we help them identify the assets that are already there in the community that can be brought forth in a way to affect positive change.
What are some recent successes and lessons that you've learned along the way?
KaBOOM has built over 3,000 playgrounds in our 22-year history across the country. Each one of those projects is a new lesson learned or a jewel. But there's one project in particular that comes to mind that occurred this year. Back in March, we were approached by former Secretary of Education Arnie Duncan, who's now the managing partner of Chicago CRED, creating real economic destiny. And his organization has one sole purpose, and that's to reduce gun violence in Chicago. He approached us because two rival gangs had agreed to lay down their arms. They had negotiated a truce. And they asked them, well, what do you want? And they said, we want a place for our kids to play. And it's a reminder that our kids are oftentimes a way to bring us together. You know, there's more that binds us than separates us. And if we can find a goal that we all agree upon, like our kids, we find new ways of working together. Fast forward to this past August, We built a playground. Many of the gang members came out, the community came out, and through the support of the Chicago White Sox, we built an awesome play space. Second lesson learned, when you're doing something great, others will join in and help and support. Also, transformation doesn't take a long time. In this instance, we built that playground in 5 months. So sometimes change can happen very quickly.
Our report found that younger and minority donors want to be approached more by charities, and they say that they would be willing to give more if approached. Have you found minority communities to be open to engagement and solicitation?
When people are asked, when we acknowledge and celebrate the talents that they can bring to the table, be it cooking food for the group or participating in creating a mural or getting a ratchet and helping to build a playground, that people respond. And we rely on local champions there within the community to help get the word out, to help provoke interest. But we oftentimes, at practically all the time, see a tremendous response from those communities.
Roxanne, I want to thank you for sharing your reactions and insights. To learn more about the Give.org Donor Trust Report, please visit us at give.org.